Today we will be discussing about finasteride, and all the facts that I'll share with you will be backed by scientific studies. We'll discuss all the aspects of finasteride from beginning till the end. There are only two FDA-approved drugs for the treatment of male pattern baldness. One is finasteride and the other is minoxidil. All other treatments like platelet-rich plasma, low-light laser therapy, stem cell treatments, they are all not FDA-approved and there is not much scientific data about their efficacy. Finasteride was first approved for the treatment of benign prostatic hyperplasia in 1992. When men with those conditions started taking finasteride, they started observing hair degrowth and they also saw that their baldness has stopped progressing. Thereafter, in 1997, finasteride 1 mg was also approved by the FDA for treatment of male pattern baldness. So what does finasteride do? When someone starts taking finasteride, their thin miniaturized hair gradually become thick, longer and denser, and they become cosmetically significant. Earlier, when they could not be picked up on pictures or photographs, they start getting noticeable even on the photographs. How long one should take finasteride? The answer is lifelong, because you need to take finasteride as long as you need hair. The mechanism of action of finasteride. So what happens is, there is an enzyme called 5-alpha reductase which converts testosterone to dihydrotestosterone. Finasteride inhibits this particular enzyme. The 5-alpha reductase enzyme has three isoforms: type 1, type 2 and type 3. Type 1 is present in the skin, hair follicle and sebaceous gland, prostate, liver and kidney. Type 2 is present in hair follicle and male reproductive organs, and type 3 is present in the central nervous system. Finasteride inhibits both type 2 and type 3 isoforms of 5-alpha reductase. The other drug, the dutasteride, inhibits all the three isoforms of 5-alpha reductase.